So starting from the introduction to machine learning, and the first part we will see today, that is the basics of the machine learning, and we will also cover the second important part, that is prerequisites part of the machine learning. Whenever you have any doubt, you can ask me. No need to give the more detail about myself. Each and everything is mentioned over here, so you can note down each and everything from this slide. And every PPT of the first slide will contain the MIT tool, so you can get the entire detail from the PPT of the slide. So if talking about this subject or this course, as we know, the course code is CSA 4008. Course title is Applied Machine Learning, and this course is LTP. So LTP, as we know, the lecture, tutorial, and practical. What I have planned in this, in a week, we have the three different classes, three different lectures. So I divided my lecture into two different parts. One is a two theory and one is practical. So I will go some practical part in a class in a week. So this is my plan. I will go, I will use this kind of a phenomena as I use into the, my different courses. So far I have done. So if we're talking about the course credit, that is the core credit. So no need to discuss more detail about over here, because this is just idea about the course only. If talking about the course objective, as we are studying the applied machine learning, so first objective is, that is to understand the concept of the supervised and unsupervised learning technique. Okay, student, let me know right now, it is visible to all, the course objective?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir.
Good. So to understand the concept of the supervised and unsupervised learning technique is saying to us, the first objective is saying to us, in talking about the machine learning, then before understanding the supervised and unsupervised learning technique, we must aware about the machine learning. What is the mean by the machine learning? So to cover up this objective, we will see what is mean by the machine learning objectives, machine learning importance, machine learning applications, and need of the machine learning, and definition of the machine learning, other things. But when talking about the supervised and supervised learning technique of the machine learning, is saying to us, it is a flavor of the machine learning. But by default, we have the two different flavors of the machine learning. Those are the supervised and unsupervised. But practically, we have the three different kinds of flavor. We have the supervised and unsupervised, as well as the semi-supervised. The semi-supervised machine learning is known as the reinforcement learning. And that is a third kind of the machine learning. We will see into the third module, as the time permits, we will. One by one, step by step, we will go to the deeply manner. So machine learning basically follow the some concept from the mathematics. Second objective is saying was to analyze the regression classification and clustering technique and the implement their outcomes. So as we know, the regression classification clustering are basically some techniques which belong to the mathematical aspect. So as I'm speaking about the regression. So what is mean by the regression? A regression basically a mathematical model. So you have to keep in mind something. That is a machine learning subject. Machine learning is especially about is a mathematical model. So in the regression, what we need to do, we have the two different important aspects. So those are the dependent variable or independent variable. So independent variable and dependent variable are the important part of the regression, which define that is how you can regrade your information, regressive your information. So whenever you need to regressive your information, two important aspects is required. One is the dependent, independent, or we can say predictive information or unpredictive information. So whenever we have the unpredictive information, or that is the independent variable, so on the value of the independent variable, we can define or we can identify the predictive information, or we can say the dependent information. Just like say, I'm just taking simple example. If you're attending the class regularly, so based on your attendance, your marks will be generated. So if your attendance is less than 90, so you will get the 4 marks. But your attendance is more than 90% or equal to 90%, then you will get the 5 marks. So this is what the marks is basically a variable which is depend on your attendance. So attendance is independent variable. So this is just idea about the regression mathematical model. So such kind of the mathematical model we will learn into the machine learning model. And now classification, I'm talking about the classification. Classification is saying to us, we can classify the information into two different parts or more than two different parts. See, I can classify the student or by the two different pattern, by the two different classification. One is male and female. But what is the parameter? That is gender. So on the basis of gender parameter, I can classify the information. Or by the student stream, I can classify the student like a student belong to a CS computer and stream, student belong to the mechanical stream, or student belong to the other kind of the stream. So classification can be done by the some parameter based on the some classify parameter. But you are talking about the clustering. So in the clustering technique, we know as a cluster. Cluster means we are grouping. Like I need to choose only the red color ball. So we are not worrying about the size of the ball. We are not about the structure of the ball. We are not worrying about the weight of the ball. We are just classifying the ball, or we are grouping the ball in base of the color. So color based grouping we can do. So this is what is a clustering. So other parameter we will not see. We will not touch the other parameter. We will see only the its color parameter. So based on the color parameter, we will make a group of the red balls. So this is a kind of the example. We can say all these examples are belong to the real world problems, and these all these problems will be implemented into the machine learning algorithm. So machine learning algorithm are predefined or existing algorithm. These are known as the machine learning models. Okay, so these are the two different objectives as I told. But when talking about the third objective of machine learning subject is saying to us, so where you need to perform the some techniques which are already defined by the machine learning methods, so machine learning models, then how you can define. So as we know, there are so many algorithms in our sorting algorithm. If you want to do sorted numbers, or if you want to sort a list of the numbers, so there are so many algorithms in the data structure. We have seen what are those algorithms. Those are quick sort, merge sort, bubble sort, insert sort, selection sort. But why are you using for the quick sort? Why? Because on the time complexity factor, as we know, the quick sort has the minimum complexity. So of course I will choose the quick sort for the sorting the numbers. So this is the point when we can say, whenever talking about the machine learning algorithms, so we have the huge number of the or number of the various algorithms. Numerous number of algorithms. So, but which algorithm I should pick? So that is defined by the performance. So of course we will see each and everything by the practical. So how to measure the performance of an algorithm? So definitely measure of the performance can be done by the accuracy of the algorithm. So based on the accuracy of the number, we can see this is the best algorithm, this is a better algorithm than the previous or other algorithm. So this is the performance of the measure of the performance we can see. So this is our course objective, and we will see each and everything properly. Okay, so now let me know this course objective is clear to all. Yes, student, please tell me.
Yes, it's clear.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so any yes, doubt sir. Any doubt to understand the course objectives, please let it be. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, so I'm just moving to my next. Okay, I'm just moving to my next page. Now, course outcomes. So, what are the course outcomes after learning or after during the learning of this machine learning course? See, identify.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please tell me.
Nothing, sir. Your slide was not visible, so I interrupted. Now it's visible.
Now it's visible.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
Okay, it's okay. No problem. So, course outcomes. So when talking about the course outcomes, here we have the 4-5 course outcomes from the syllabus. So first one, we have to identify the characteristics of the machine learning that makes it useful to the solve real world problem. So as I told you, while talking about the regression, classification, clustering problem, so all these problems are following by the real world problem. So a real world problem can be understood by the some examples, say to forecast the weather of the today. Okay. To forecast the share market and to predict some information. So these are the real world problems we can say. Suppose you are taking the class and you are not able to some class, so there is some prediction we can say. But why you are not taking the class? That could be the real world problem. So if we have the problem, then by the machine, how we can identify the problem? So machine can identify the problem based on the past experiences. Say in the coming slide you will see some example, and I will tell you some example in proper way, you can understand very well manner. So course outcome is saying that is, if you want to implement the machine learning model in proper way, then you must follow the real world problem. But truly speaking, we are not study the any subjective which belong to the child's nature. Now we are not talking about the non-procedural programming. We are not talking about some other kind of a thing. We are not talking about the non-objective programming. See, here we are talking about the problem which belong to the real world problem. So in C programming, the real world problem can't be solved, but in C programming we can't able to we can we are able to solve. Why? Because in C++ we have the object entity by which we can solve the real world problem. And the same thing we can go through the Java and Python. Why? Because these are the programming language which support the real world problems as a real world solution, real world problems solution. So course outcomes, we can say the machine learning will help to motivate to solve the real world problem. Talking about the second course outcomes, so it provides a solution for the classification and regression approach and real-world application, as I told you, and it was on my previous slide. I already told you so many things about this part. So classification, how we can classify, and how we can regressive do the any problem. They were talking about the third objective, outcomes is saying to us, choose an appropriate clustering technique to solve real-world problems. So clustering techniques are so many clustering techniques. So which clustering approach is better or technique is better? So in this course, you will see what are the various clustering techniques by which we can go through such technique, and that could be supervisor and supervisor. Okay. But now question comes over here, what do you mean by the supervisor and supervisor? Supervisor means you are talking about the label data, and unsupervised means you are talking about the unlabeled data. In supervised, we can say we know the data, what the data which belong to the our problems. But in unlabeled data, there is no guarantee the data which is selected or chosen by us that is applicable to the, our problems. So here we have the unlabeled data. But when we have the data which is selected or chosen by us, that is a labeled data, means there is a guarantee that particular problems can be sorted out from the such data. So here we have the unlabeled data, and these data based information, we can filter out the information or we can grouping the information into the cluster base. So that is a third outcome. If we're talking about the fourth one, to understand the methods to reduce the dimension of the data set using the machine learning modeling algorithms. See, we have the so many information. We have the so many information by which we can collect the data. So information collection is a basically activity or task you can collect. But after collecting the information, you have a set of the such information, and that is known as the data set. But some information are meaningless from the data set. So thus, from data set, you are having from the thousand. Suppose you have 1,000 information. But from the 1,000 information, we are getting the same information that could be retrieved by the 300 information. So and 700 information which are compromising or which is compromising or integrated by the generated, there is no meaning. So why we are having the such information? So such information should be reduced. So at the time, the unsupervised learning having a technique which is known as dimensionality reduction. So by using the dimensionality reduction approach, we can reduce the dimension or we can reduce the information from the data set. And that is to be also part of our machine learning outcomes. So that is a we need to take care of into the proper way. Fifth course outcome is saying to us that an indicator suitable machine learning model implement and examining the performance of the chosen model for a given real world problem. So of course, in the real world problem, we have to choose the appropriate machine learning model and implement and examine. Examining means we need to check or test whether the model is perfect to the specific problem or not. So these are the five different course outcomes which describes to us where you need to look into your machine learning course into the proper way or not. So if you're looking the machine learning course in the proper way, then at least these five course outcomes you must have. Okay, so now tell me any doubt here in this, any doubt in here in the course outcomes? Yes, student, tell me any doubt. Any course outcome which is unable to understand to you?
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yes, please tell me.
The thing is regarding not just course outcomes, but of the also the course objectives too.
Yes.
The thing is, so we know that like in this course we'll learn about the supervised and unsupervised like techniques, and then we'll dive deeper into different types of supervised and unsupervised, and also the evaluation matrices. But the main problem comes into data, right? So aren't we studying about like some data mining techniques? Because before applying a machine learning model, we need to analyze if the data is proper or not. So see, a thorough study regarding that.
We have so many and exercise. We have a thousand exercise. I can help you and I can solve all those problems within the time period. But we need to cover or we need to look into the syllabus first. So if time permits, definitely I will tell you so many things. And in between, if your time permits, then I will share the some information to all the students. And you can go through all those information. Even I will share the some code. So by which you can easily sort out the problem. And if you're doing something which is extra, which is other thing from the syllabus, and you have endowed, then at a time you can ask me such problem, then I will help you. So don't worry about those parts. Now, so I'm coming to the syllabus part, then let us see what are the portions we need to look into our syllabus part. First, we need to give the priority to cover the syllabus, and we need to take care of the other students as well who are new into this course. Okay, now you may be the champion of the machine learning, but other student has to look into this matter. Other student has to start the beginning of the machine learning. So I will start from the very beginning of in the scratch mode to learn the machine learning. Okay, so I need to take care of the other student as well. Maybe you will be the champion of the machine learning, but the other student has to take care of the subject properly. This is not a matter of the marks, it's not a matter of the other thing. This is a matter of the learning. Okay.
So actually I get it, and I am thinking in that perspective too, because directly applying or learning about machine learning techniques won't help us if the data is not proper.
I will tell you how to create a database. I will tell you so many things. So if you are having a model which is very simple model, so of course with the help of the debt model, if we need to use a existing data set, then definitely we can use a existing data set to implement our work. Else we will define our own data set and we will work on that. So there will be no issue. So I need to start this course as a practically from the very beginning. So first I will cover some theoretical part, then practical, then theory, then cover practical. And this is the phenomenon I will take into the my class.
Okay, yeah, fine, sir.
Got it. So don't worry. So
yeah.
If I'm probably, I'm just saying to all, if I do the practical over here, then you will see then what is happening over here. See, I will implement some models over here and I will give some exercise to you and then try to implement your model at your level. And I will share some code of the model into the Python programming code and then implement and then see, do some changes into the variable parameters and see what is differences and what is the output we are getting. So don't worry about that, but just let us understand from very beginning part. At least I will take 1 week to cover some theoretical part, and I will cover first module and second module parallelly. So let me come to the syllabus part, then we will discuss. Okay, don't worry. Other than all these problems, so you have any problem, then you can ask.
Okay, no sir, there is no problem.
Okay, good. So this is a course out. So now this is the syllabus part. That is unit 1 or module 1. This module is telling to us introduction to machine learning. In this module, what we need to do? We will see what it means by the machine learning, what are the various type of the machine learning. Definitely you can see over here, supervised and supervising for learning, some theory part of the learning, what it means by the learning and feasibility of learning. See, while implementing anything, there is some chance we are not putting the perfect model. There may be some error, there may be some bug. So those errors, some noise, we will see. And we will see if you are having a data set. So how, if you are having own data set or other data set, then what is mean by the training data set or testing data set? So all these theoretical part we will cover into this first module. Okay, there are some definition part, and while they're taking some pictures, while taking some images, we will see some theoretical part. So of course, but when talking about the practical part, so I will start practical from the this module, that is a supervised learning. So our first module and second module will run parallelly. Okay, so you have to take care of this all these points properly. Two classes will be changed into the theoretical part, and other last one for one that would be from the practical part. So I will do some practical over here to help you what it means by this part. And suppose I'm talking about right now the regression. So what is mean by the regression and how to implement the linear regression? Okay. So I will demonstrate what I mean by the linear regression to the practical, then you will understand, yes, this is happening over here. So parallelly, the supervised parallelly in module 1 or module 2, or unit 1 and unit 2 will run simultaneously. So some practical part is required, then I will give some exercise to you, then you will implement. Okay, so this is the second module, that is supervised learning, where we need to take care about the regression, where we need to take care about the some information about the neural network, as you can see. See, neural network is why neural network? Because in the talking about the machine learning, so when a machine need to perform many operations, so it is all the information is derived from the network, and that network is a neural network. So the question comes in a moment, what is meant by the neuron? See, neuron is basically is a part of the brain or mind where the information to be flow. Okay, so when the information is to be flown, then that is the actual brain or actual neuron. But a person can't use actual brain to implement into the machine. So some artificial neuron is required. So what is coming, that is in our mind, that is artificial neural network. So we will see what it means by the neuron, what it means by the neural network, and how neural network will work. And at the time, we have some important terms. Those are the perceptron, multilayer perceptron. Okay, so these are the part of the supervised learning. So first, we need to take care of the our machine learning syllabus. See, this is the syllabus. Any subject syllabus will not be completed in a year because there are so many things in any subject. But if we need to take care of the, all those points properly, step by step, and first we need to complete the syllabus. Then if time permits, then I will share some information to you, and then you can go through all those points. So support vector machine. Support vector machine basically supervised learning model. And this is my research area. I'm working on the supervised learning based on the support vector machine. So on the support vector machine, I have published two papers, and two papers have already communicated. So this is my very interesting part of the support vector machine. So I will explain each and everything from the supervised. And from the entire syllabus, I will tell you by the practical way or by the explanation through the images. Maybe there's some animation part. So you will be happy to know the each and every concept properly. So this is supervised learning model. And this is all, this is an introduction part of the machine learning. And if you're talking about ensemble learning and unsupervised learning. So see, ensemble learning means we're talking about integrated learning. Means the two models can be the part of the model. Of course, it is going to be possible. So that is known as ensemble learning. But when talking about the unsupervised learning, it means we are talking about the unlabeled data. So unlabeled data means clustering. Now, see, in the clustering, suppose I need to choose green color balls, but we are not bothering about the size. Ball may be small size, big size, medium size. Okay, we are not talking about the its weight. We are not talking about its diameter. So other parameter, other information we are leaving. That is a main feature. But in the unsupervised learning, we are leaving such thing because that is the unlabeled. But we are only talking about the its color. So only the based on the one parameter, we are just justifying that is that this is the right color. Okay, so we have a clustering. So clustering basically is an approach method or technique which is part of the unsupervised learning. Okay. So say all these three things, so many things we will see into the unsupervised learning. I have a chart by which I will tell you which algorithm becomes to be the part of the supervised or unsupervised learning. And this is the most important part. But here we have the dimensional reduction and PCA, that is the principal component analysis of that is PCA. So that is the interesting part of the unsupervised learning. So student, you are not worry about each and everything from the this course. I will provide source code, I will provide the code, I will provide the PPT, I will provide so many materials from the machine learning subject. Don't worry about that part. What is written over here, that is random forest tree. Okay, the random forest tree itself is unsupervised learning, and that is inspired from the tree, from the data structure. So of course, how we can use such thing, that is the first part. And the advanced part of this part, we have the boosting. So boosting can be implemented by the AdaBoost algorithm. So we will implement the AdaBoost algorithm. How we can implement, that is necessary. So ensemble learning and supervised learning will be the part of our machine learning. See, after the two or three classes, maybe after the 3 to 5 classes, 4 to 5 classes, you will see what is the flow we are going through that. And you could be happy to meet the practical part. That is, I'm damn sure about that. don't worry about the practical part. Okay, don't think about the notes, don't think about the other thing. You will get each and everything from the Google Classroom. So I have to just drop a message about the Google Classroom, the MS Team. You can find each and everything from there. And the Google Classroom, you can get the notes, you can find the ebooks, you can find the videos, the things. Don't worry about each and everything. Okay, so please go through all those parts properly and don't miss any class. When you're leaving any class, definitely you will not learn anything from the class. But I can help you only to provide the notes. I can help you to justify the answer. But something you have to do. Something means you have to do a study in practice. So this is the ensemble learning and supervised learning, as I told you. So don't worry about that part. I will tell you in more detail properly. Okay. So don't worry about that. See, reinforcement learning. The third one is known as the reinforcement learning. That is also sometimes known as the semi-supervised learning. The reinforcement learning is totally machine learning flavor, which is mostly used for to develop the game or in the game, whenever you need to implement the machine learning, that you can go through the reinforcement learning. Because in a game, there are two possibilities. One is you can either can win or you can lose. If you're winning, then you are going through the one position. You are going to the, changing your bit. But you are losing, then you are going to the another, you are choosing the answer, that could be zero. So there are some policies to play a game. There are some rules on the play to game. So depends on the some rules and policy, we need to choose what is the flow of the, our information. And that is also defined by the machine learning and the its flavor, that is the reinforcement. So we will see all this part properly. If talking about the neural network, this is the last module, or this would be our last module, neural network. So after learning the introduction about the machine neural network into the machine learning, then we will see each and everything with the practical. So definitely, rather than the theoretical part, I will tell you this in the practical way, then you will be happy to know what is happening into the machine learning. So neural network with practical into the Python programming, you will get the detail from here. So I'm just giving you some assurance. Don't worry about the neural network, some implementation to the Python programming. I will tell you what is happening over here. Okay, so don't worry about that one. But the word that is written over here, backpropagation. Backpropagation basically is a totally, we can do by the mathematically. So mathematically means we will solve the derivation of the backpropagation by backpropagation required. So after generating some information, whenever you need to check your information is not accurate with your other results. Just let me explain some idea over here, then you will be happy to know your answer. See, just suppose A is a layer. After something work over here, we are just moving to the another layer, that is B layer. Then you are moving to the another layer C, and after getting all the, after performing some operation on this layer, you are getting your output, that is a D. Suppose D is our output here. Okay, I will tell you what are the various layers into the neural network. That is input layer and output layer. Okay. And so input layer, output layer, header layer. So there are three different layers in a neural network. But from performing all these operations with this layer, we are getting the output. Suppose on the D, we are getting the output 0.9. But we are expecting the answer 0.99. Okay, 0.99. So you know the 0.99 is bigger value than the 0.9, and which was our expected answer. This was our expected answer, but actually we are getting right now 0.9. So there's a little bit difference between the 0.9 and 0.99. So what we'll do, we will jump again here into the its previous layer, then previous layer, then the previous layer. So what we are doing, we are moving back to generate the new result, and that is known as the backpropagation. And that part we will implement into the our machine into the machine learning through the Python programming. And that is the most interesting part. Backpropagation. This module, I will tell you some theoretical way or some numerical way with the help of the some practical. Then you will understand this unit within the 5 to 6 lectures properly. Entire concept you will understand properly. Okay. Now, tell me, any doubt here in these modules, 5 different modules? 1 and 2 will do simultaneously. 1 and 2 will do simultaneously. 3rd we will see, and 4 we will see, and 5th we will see proper. Each and everything will be done by the proper way. Yes, tell me any doubt so far? Any doubt into the any doubt from the syllabus part you can ask. Yes, student, please speak something.
No doubt, sir.
Okay, good.
No doubt, sir.
Okay, good. So, because if you're speaking something over there, then I will be happy to know you are still waking. Okay, waking up. Okay. So now books and e-books. Five books I'm just suggesting to all from your syllabus part. I have e-books and I will drop all e-books on the Google Classroom. From here, you can collect it. So without any doubt, you can collect your books and e-books from the Google Classroom. All these five e-books. List of the experiment as per the syllabus. Please note down this point in your mind. List of the experiment as per your syllabus. So what I mean to say that these are the predefined practical we have all, but instead of these practical, we will do some other practical, like see in the logistic regression. We have only the logistic regression, but I will show you how to implement the linear regression. Okay, how to implement the linear regression. Okay. Because it is a kind of a regression, so we will see all these activity properly with the practical. So other than all of these practical, we will try to cover up the more and more practical for learning the machine learning proper way. Okay, so don't worry about all this part. It's my promise. I will come to it the most and most practical into practical way. And if time is not permitting to us, then I will share the code and you can just copy the code into the Jupyter notebook or whatever notebook, whatever Python node ID you are using, you can use and just copy and paste and try to run. Okay. Whenever you feel any problem, then you can just drop me a message and I will sort out your problem. So don't worry about it. So other than these practicals, we will do some other practical more in briefly. And we will not start the practical directly like dysentery implementation. No. You can do, why you are starting the directly the this big practical. We will start from the very beginning, scratch, because you have to keep in your mind, you are new in this course, you don't know anything. So I'm expecting you don't know anything. So as a very beginning part from the very scratch, I will tell you each and everything from the very beginning. So starting from the just like A, starting from the ABCD. So you know, you don't know the anything into the this course, you don't know anything about the machine learning, and I will tell you what you mean by the machine learning and how to implement the machine learning properly. So this kind of a phenomena I will tell you in proper way. So this is a list of experiment. Other than the list of experiment we will discuss, I will give you some time to time, okay, based on your time, based on your performance. So I will share the code properly. So here I have just simple question. So let us start the course, or do you have any doubt, then you can ask me. Just tell me, should we start or should we start the course, or any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
So anything I just told you, so many things about the machine learning, what we will discuss, what are the expectations we have in this course, here you don't have any doubt, or you all people don't have any doubt, and shall we start or shall we continue?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I'm just moving to the next slide. That is very beginning part. That is saying to us preface of the machine learning. Okay. So preface of the machine learning basically is saying to us what is mean by the machine learning and what is the application of the machine learning. Just let me inform you to all my dear students, those who are new into the course, those who are new to me as well. I will give the information in theoretical part into the my PPT, because in the online mode we are taking classes. So I will put theoretical part into the my PPT for understanding purpose or for notes purpose only. So don't think about this, sir. You are putting the lots of the content over into the PPT rather than that you should have a limited content. Okay, I can have, but I will believe into explain concept with the some theoretical part. So after reading all these notes, you will be happy to know the concept. So you are not required to go other things. You just read only the my PPT, then you can understand the concept properly. If you want to skip such a slide, then you can skip. So I just put the some theoretical part, I put the some numerical, I put the some each and everything images properly. So my aim to explain the concept properly by giving the some theoretical aspect, because you are not ready to make a notes. So I'm just providing a note from the PPT as well. Okay. So preface of the machine learning, you're saying to us, machine learning basically is what? Machine learning is what? Machine learning is what? This is the question. Three times I'm speaking, machine learning is what? It means there are two words in the machine learning, in the machine and learning. So machine will learn something from the past experiences. Okay. When machine will learn something from the past experiences, just like human will learn. So human will learn from the past experiences to know, to identify something or to assume something or to predict something. The same thing, if the machine will learn something from the past experiences, and that is time we have the machine learning. But how to know what are the information that is we have? So of course, based on the data set, based on the some information, we will feed into the our machine learning, and that machine learning model or machine learning algorithm will interpret. So interpretation computation is required by some algorithm. So that's why we have the machine learning algorithm. So let me study some parts. Let me read out some points over here, then you can understand. Machine learning is what? It is an integral part of the many commercial application research projects today in area of the ranging from the medical diagnosis and treatment, of course. Because in today's era, most recently or nowadays, we are going through the research area, then image classification, image segmentations, and image diagnosis, image from the images, we are getting to know what are the diseases a particular person is having, just like the cancer or other things. So definitely medical image is medical imaging. We say medical imaging is an area where the machine learning is play important role to find the diseases from the human body. And according to the, we can suggest some diseases. So it will help the doctor or physicians to know the disease from the particular person, what the disease he or she has. Okay, so this is the point. And instead of this kind of the application, we can say the we are tweeting something to, we are having some information on the Facebook, then finally, each and every information is flowing and flowing so many places. And finally, we are getting the same information. It means each and everything is connected. So on the social media, social network, machine learning is also play important role. There are not a specific application of the machine learning. There are lots of use of the application of the machine learning where you can find in easy way without any doubt. So instead of the other application, machine learning can be applicable into the aircraft or available into the bank, available to the finance sector, education sector, everywhere. Finance sector and real application, I will tell you the last of the class with an example. But before that, let us understand what it means by the machine learning. So the preface of machine learning is saying to us, we can use the machine, uses of the machine. Okay, so this is my point. So this is just idea. And one thing I want to tell you, definitely you need to predict something on the global warming. Like, so last 10 years, 20 years, number of the glaciers are melting. So maybe the 5 years prediction can be identified by the machine learning approach. Number of glaciers may be melted. Okay. So this is the prediction can be done by, or can be computed or can be calculated by the machine learning approaches. So this is just idea about the machine learning. Okay, now tell me any doubt in this slide. Because slide by slide we will move. Please tell me any doubt?
No doubt, sir. We can move forward.
Okay. So we need to keep in mind about some historical part as well. We are going through any subject. So I will skip soon, but let me give you some information within 2 or 3 minutes. Machine learning, just the term which was coined by the Arthur Samuels in 1959. And who is the Arthur Samuels? Basically, he is a pioneer of the artificial intelligence. Basically, who is the father or the founder of the artificial intelligence? So artificial intelligence, what is artificial intelligence? I will tell you to the 2-3 scan. Then, but let me clear to all. Arthur Samuels is the father or founder of the this artificial intelligence. But what is artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence means how to make a machine as an intelligence. See, machine is an artificial, it is not a human. So we are making a machine as a human, and which is not actual or real human, that is the artificial human. That is time we are say we are following the artificial intelligence. So we are making machine as intelligence brought by some artificial sense, artificially, not a human. Not a human, so The machine does not have a actual human brain, and machine does not have actual liver, kidney, okay, heart. The machine has only the artificial heart, okay, has an artificial brain. So that's why we have the human, and that is also known by the robots, okay. So humanoid robot, we can say humanoid robot. So where the idea is coming from, the Arthur Samuel. So I just put it over here, the theoretical part. You can read out all the theoretical part from here, then you can go through it. But this term is coined by the Arthur Samuel in 1959. But what is the actual definition which is given by the Tom and Mitchell? So Tom and Mitchell definition is purely actual information mathematics in the mathematics way, and you will be happy to know the this term. So from the internet, so many internet society, from the various internet, so you can find out so many definitions, but this is the actual definition of the machine learning according to me, as well as the internet society, you can find out the same thing. So let me give you some idea. A computer program is said to learn from the experience E with respect to some class of the task T and performance measure P, its performance at task in T as measured by P. So improve with experience E. Let me explain this example by simple way you can understand. Suppose I have the 10 years data. I have 10 years data of, I have 10 years of the data. Okay, 10 years of the data. I have the 10 years of data. That is, we can say this is a set of the task. Can we say this is a set of the task? Yes, please let me know. Can we say this is a set of the task? Yes, please tell me. Can we say this is a set of the task? Last 10 years of data I have to predict something.
Yes.
So yes, I can write this set of the task like the capital T. Okay. So what do I mean to say that a computer program is set to learn from the experience? So here we have some words we need to keep in mind. Experience E with respect to some class of the task, that is, we can say the T, and we need to measure some performance, that is, we have the P. Okay, so how we can measure the performance T? So let me just put it some information and you can understand. Suppose, so what is the, my questions? My question is very simple question. On 4th February, 2021, on the 4th February 2021, what would be the temperature, or what would be the temperature of, what would be the temperature of the Delhi city? This is a simple one. What would be the temperature of the Delhi city? This is a simple example I'm taking, then you can understand. Just let me know the question is clear to all. On 4th February 2020, what would be the temperature of the Delhi city? Just let me know. The question is clear to all.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So 10 years data I can put over here. 4th February 2020, 4th February 2019 and 18, 17. And so the last 10 years data I have over here. So I have here the year and I have the temperature of the specific day, the 10 years. So this is what, this is a some class of the task T. So I have over here, this is a class of task. So I just put it over here. What was my problem? I need to find the 4th February 2021, what was the temperature of Delhi city? So Delhi city temperature of the 2020, 2090, 2080, and so on, so 2010. So I have this data. So what is my new experience? What is why my experience? So this data just basically keep the information from the past experience. So the temperature information, which is contained by the year, respectively year, this is about, this is the experience actually. This, all this set of the task, which is contained by the some temperature. So this is what, this is the experience. This is experience of year, with respect to year. Experience with respect to, we can say experience with respect to year. So we have some data or we have some experience with respect to year, and these two fields are making as a set of the task or class of task. Now, whenever I need to check the temperature of the Delhi city, what would be the temperature of the tomorrow? What would be the temperature of the Delhi city? So we have some value. So we can predict some information, there would be some temperature around 32.5 something. Okay, maximum temperature 32.5. So this is what, this is your expected output. This would be your expected output. Now suppose suddenly there's some change into the weather, and we are expecting there would be temperature on the 4th February 2020 of the city 32.5 maximum. But unfortunately, due to the weather is not good, we got or we found the answer 20 degree. This is the actual. This was our expected, but this is the actual. Now what happened at the time? So this temperature will also be stored into the our set of the class or our task table to update the new experience, to update the new experience for the coming years, okay, or maybe the new years. Now then, see if you can read, if its performance and set of task T as measured by the P improved with the experience T. So what is the new experience we found? We are expecting the temperature should be, temperature can be, temperature would be 32.5, but actual output we are getting temperature, tomorrow temperature is 20.0. Now let us see it. So after what we get, say 20 degree temperature was down, you are expecting 32. So I did not wear the two sweaters, but after getting the 20 temperature, I need to wear the two sweaters right now. So we have the tentative or we are a predictive information. We are not saying we are having the actual information. We are having the predictive information. So this predictive information can be measured by the machine learning. So in the machine learning, we are not putting code. We are not writing something. We are giving the information based on the previous information. So we are expecting there could be something, but we are not saying that we are getting the actual output. But in machine learning, what is happening there? We are having the good accuracy, depend on the models. So suppose our model is providing the good accuracy or more than a 95% accuracy. So if actual output, suppose actual output is 32 degree. So we can say now we are getting the good result. So this is the machine learning. So why machine learning is popular? Because we are getting the accurate result, or not 100% accurate. We are getting the 90 to 95% accurate result from the machine learning. We are getting. So that's why the machine learning is most popular. So the computer program is set to learn from the experience E. What is experience? As I told you, with respect to some class of task T, and performance measure P, with its performance at task T, as measured by performance P. And it improves the performance, it improves the experience E. So we are improving the experience. The coming year, we will update the information. Coming year, we will update the information. And finally, maybe after some times, we will see we have the huge amount of the data. Now, last 10 years, we are getting the 32 something. But if we go through the last 10 years record data, so maybe we can get the 32.3 degree. 32.3 is close to the 32.5 rather than the 32 degrees. So definitely that you're having the huge amount of data, and this is a data set. So if you have a huge amount of data, then what we have? We can find the good accuracy, and few things depend on the algorithm. So this is just idea about the machine learning. Now tell me, is it clear to all right now? Yes, please tell me, is it clear to all? Any doubt, please you can ask me. Yes, tell me, speak clearly. Yes, student, tell me, any doubt? Say, I need a voice.
No, sir.
Okay, any doubt so far?
No, sir.
Okay, so shall I move to the next slide?
Yes.
Okay, so far what we have seen? We have seen the, what do you mean by the machine learning, and where we can use the machine learning. So with this definition, I just written this definition into some example form. So you can say what is machine learning. So you have to keep in mind all during your entire life, what do you mean by the machine learning? This definition, that is Tom and Michelle. Okay. their definition is more interesting and definition, and this is the actual definition which is to be implemented really. Other than this definition, you can define the machine learning like this one. Okay, just let me know this. What is machine learning? Is PPT slide is visible to all? Let me know. The slide is visible to all?
Yes, it's visible.
Yes.
So from this point, you can understand what is mean by the machine learning. Machine learning is a concept, a model or technique, which allows the machine to learn from the example and experiences. Now see, the previous definition is completely written here into the form of theoretical. So machine learning is a complete model or machine concept or technology that is used to learn something from the experience or example. So what is the experience behind? We have the last 10 years data, or last 50 years data, or last 100 years data. Okay. And that too without being explicitly programmed. So in the machine learning, we are not writing anything into the programming lingo. We are using the existing algorithm to implement the machine learning model. So we are not designing, we are not writing any new model. We are using the existing model to predict some information to get the output. So instead of writing the code, what do you do? What you do is you feed the data to the generic algorithm. And what are the generic algorithm? Generic algorithm means I'm talking about the predefined algorithms. And algorithm machine will do logic based on given data. So what the data I will feed, and based on the my fitted data, the logic will be generated. And what is the information I fitted given data? What is the given data? Last 10 years data. Okay. Last 10 years data. So I have fit into the my model, and I'm using any algorithm, predefined algorithm. And based on the thing, what would be the output? I'm getting the production. I'm getting the production of the weather of fourth February. Okay. So this is the thing. Now see, let me clear. This is the definition which is given by the Tom and Michelle. And this is a general definition. This general definition also having the same sense as we have seen in the previous slide. So now tell me, any doubt here? What is mean by the machine learning? If you have any doubt, please, you can ask me right now. Else after 2 or 3 days, you will say, sir, can you repeat again the what you mean by the machine learning? So it will not be good for me. So to better idea, let us clear right now. Yes, please tell me, any doubt? What is meant by the machine learning? Please, please inform me.
No, sir.
So, if all student is now are not having any problem over here, then shall I move to the next slide?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'm just moving to the next slide. Just see. I'm talking about the artificial, it's a part of the machine learning, it's a part of the subset. So how we can say, so this is the proof. Now see, machine learning basically is the father of the, machine learning is a, basically is a son of the artificial intelligence. Or we can say it's a subset of the artificial intelligence. It is the father of deep learning, we can say. So machine learning basically a subset of the artificial intelligence. But now question comes in our mind, what is mean by the machine artificial intelligence? So first let us clear what is mean by the artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence means this is a study of the computer science and engineering subject where we can see, where we can learn how we can make a machine as intelligence. See, machine is having their own senses, but those senses will be the artificial. Machine can speak. Machine can speak. How can we say machine can speak? Of course, by the speaker. Machine can speak, but by the mouth we can speak. Human can speak by the mouth, but machine can speak by the speaker only. Machine can listen something. We can, as a human, we can listen through the ear, but machine can listen through the mic only. So the devices which are connected to the machine, that all those are the senses becomes artificial. That's why we can say machine can be intelligent by the artificial way. So that is to be studied by into the computer science subject to the artificial intelligence subject. That is known as the AI. Under this course, under the subject, we will study the machine learning. So machine learning is a subset where we can use some properties or some inherited part of the AI. So machine can't smell. If machine is smelling something, so we can say another senses which is smelling is implemented to the machine. So machine can see. How machine can see? Machine can see using the camera sensors. Machine can see identify the object by the some object sensor. Machine can speak by the speaker. Machine can listen. But suppose machine can identify there is some heat. So how we can say there is thermal sensor. So by which machine can identify? So based on some sensor devices, machine can use some sensing, but machine can't have the feeling. Suppose machine is not having feeling, it means what is we can say machine does not have any idea where the machine do the anger, where machine do something or some other activity. Like I'm just taking the real example of the robot machine, the robot movie. Okay, in the robot movie, the machine was perfect. That's the perfect example, but there is no issue. But what the machine has introduced on cell a feeling sense. So when a feeling sense is introduced by machine on cell, then the machine was fell down into the lab. So this was the story. But now in the AI, practically so far, a machine can't have the sense, feeling sense. But in a human, we can have the sense. So we have the different senses, but machine can't have the so many senses. Machine have only limited sensor. In coming days, the work is going on. That the coming days, definitely some senses may can have to be highly recognized. Those are could be followed by the feeling and other senses as well. So, but that is a part of the artificial intelligence. So this is the point. But if you're talking about the machine learning, machine is what? Machine is a subset of the AI, which used to follow the statistical model. What are the statistical model? Integration, classification, okay. Clustering, of course, in the clustering, what kind of the mathematical model we have. See, for learning the machine model, machine learning, you must be aware about some basic mathematics. Those are some hypothetical. Suppose I need to identify the hypothetical information. So what hypothetical you are having? You are having null hypothesis or a non-null hypothesis? Okay, so this is the point. And you must have some idea about the vector, you must have an idea about the matrices, you must have an idea about some mathematical basic thing. Because each and everything information into the images, which is represented by the vector. In the mathematically, it is represented by the vector matrices. But into the image, that is only the bugle. But that is to be transformed into the mathematical model in form of the vector matrices. So mathematics, basic mathematics required to learn about the machine learning. So whenever we are saying that machine learning uses statistical model, means we are talking about the basic mathematics. And deep learning. See, deep learning is nothing which is just advanced version of the machine learning where we will do the activity into the deep way. Suppose you are reading a book one time, no issue, you can do it. You will be happy. When you are reading the book again, then you will be again, you will gain some more information. Again, you will read more. So if you are reading a page two or three times, then you will be, okay, there was a point. But you are just thinking about a point again, it means you are talking about it deeply. You are deeply studying the particular thing in deep, proper way that we have the deep learning. So deep learning is nothing which is just extended version of the machine learning where we can go through a deep process or deep study or deep machine learning. So deep learning is nothing which is an extended version of the machine learning where we need to move into the, we need to dive into the deeply to get the our output. So when you are diving into the deeply manner, then definitely what will be happen? We are close to the actual output. Okay, we are close to the actual output. So deep learning just provides us a better output compared to the normal machine learning output. So deep learning is so much nowadays is so much famous because we are getting the actual close to the actual output. So this is the reason between the deep learning. And now let me know once again to your side the difference between the AI machine learning and deep learning is still equal. Yes, please tell me. Is it clear to all difference between the AI and machine learning right now? Yes, student, please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so don't worry about the deep learning. So I will tell you more about the deep learning when time permits. Then I will tell you deep learning with the some other examples right now. But let us try to understand what is where the machine learning it lies. This is my point. Where the machine learning lies. Okay. So next.
Excuse me.
Yes, please ask me.
Sir, in regards to the flowchart presented here. I previously had some doubts too, but I couldn't ask anyone else. So I'll ask you right now.
Yes.
The thing is, I was according to this flowchart, machine learning is a part of artificial intelligence. But what is the segment of artificial intelligence that is not in machine learning? So we have some way, and the machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence, but artificial intelligence has its own set. So it must have something else that is not in machine learning. So I was having this question, but I couldn't ask anyone because I didn't have any mentor.
Okay, now see, you can understand artificial intelligence is just like a room. So where the machine learning like a window. So if you are not having any kind of window, so it would be also part of the room as well. So there will be no issue. So a room can have the two window, three window, many window. So in the machine learning, yes, machine learning algorithm is also part of the artificial intelligence algorithm. So previously we have studied so many algorithms that was a part of the artificial intelligence. But nowadays we have classified our information based on the circumstances. This is the machine learning, because now what we are doing, we are now depend on the machine. In today's era and last 10 years, what is happening over here? We are making machine as intelligence, and now we are making machine as intelligence. So machine will learn automatically from its defined algorithm. So it is not user dependent. So that it is also part of the AI. Now what happened? AI machine learning itself is having one sense that is known as understanding. So if you are making machine as a learning oriented, so it's just we are indirectly or directly we are implementing the understanding sense. So this is the point. So we can say AI basically is a broad area. So we are the machine learning, deep learning, even there are so many kind of the learning, we also part of the AI. That is not introduced over here. Now we can go through the AI. So there are so many component of the, so many learning, which could be the part of the AI. So AI just kind of the room, and other windows are the part of the machine learning. And in the window, we have the some grills, we have some part that is known as the deep learning. So you can understand this concept like this one.
Okay, so sir, during our first semester, we had a course called Foundation of AI.
Yes.
And in that course, we were taught different types of searching techniques with trees and graphs.
Yes.
So are those included here?
See, in AI, what we have seen the BFS algorithm, we have a DFS algorithm, we have a EO star algorithm, we have the A star algorithm. Okay, am I right?
Yes, sir.
So see, all these are the searching algorithm, which is are the part of the artificial intelligence, where we understand how machine will search an algorithm automatically followed by the various approaches. But same thing we can implement through the machine learning and deep learning. So it is also possible without any doubt. But these are, we will see. You have studied there from the Richard Knightley, am I right? This is a famous book.
Yes.
So yeah. In that book, this book was written, this was book only having the idea about the AI. But AI, it is not a small part. AI is a big part. AI is a vast part. Where we are talking about the very simple algorithm, then some algorithm are in part of the dead thing. See, what are the various applications of AI? Various applications of AI can be understood by the solving the real world problem. So we are solving the real world problem into the specific manner to make a machine as an intelligence. So we are pulling only the such part. So we are having the one learning that is known as the machine learning. But suppose in the AI, we are learning into deeply manner to image segmentation, other thing. So at a time you are having the different kind of the neural network approach. So each and everything is connected with each other. So we can't differentiate anything. Now deep learning, we are now talking about deep learning. the deep learning, we are having the CNN, that is the convolutional neural network. But when talking about the machine learning, we always focus on the neural network only. But when talking about the its various flavor like RNN, and so it's okay. We are saying there is a machine learning. But when talking about the CNN, then what happened at a time? In the CNN, we are having the different kind of the layers. We are not having the single layer. We have the multiple layers. So we are having a multiple layer, so we can say this deep learning. So there is nothing difference between the machine learning, artificial intelligence, deep learning practically, but they are the segment of each other. So that's why at what level we are doing some activity depends on us. So this is the thing. See, in the deep learning, we are inheriting some property from the machine learning. In the machine learning, we are inheriting the property from the artificial intelligence. So this is the point where we can see. See, like your grandfather. In your your father is just inheriting some property from your grandfather, but your father is just completed a postgraduate degree, but your grandfather is not. So qualification is not a big issue. Big issue is here, how many properties inherited by your grandfather to your father to you. This is general, all we need to keep in mind.
Yes.
Okay, so suppose your father is qualified the postgraduate, but your father is just only a 10th pass. So here we are not talking about the qualification. Here we are seeing the matter: who is the father and who is inheriting the property.
Yeah, exactly.
This is my point. Okay, now is it clear to all?
Okay, so yes, sir.
Okay, so now shall I move to the next slide?
Yeah, sure. If everyone's fine with it.
Yeah. See, so the question comes in your mind: what does it do? It means what machine will do while learning the something over here. See, this is a rough diagram I have taken over here, and I will tell you more detail about the various component of the machine learning in the text below. But let us understand what is happening over here. See, if we're talking about the machine learning, so it enables the computer to our machine. Listen, it enables the computers or machine. So now what machine we have, that is also a form of the computing device. So we can say computer. To make the data-driven decision rather than the being explicit programming, it means we are not writing anything into the form of the code for the machine learning. We will use only the existing model or existing algorithm to implement our machine learning model or to perform some task on the our solving the problem. So some program or some algorithm which is already designed, we will use and we will implement. How will we do and how will expose to the information? So we have some data and we will train the machine. So machine will train on the data to get the some output. So we will give some input. So we will give some input like just we will give some date, that is post February 2021. So what would be the temperature? So followed by our model or the existing model, we will predict something that could be temperature for the 32.5, 32.3, something like this one. So this is the step we will need to follow like this one. So into next class, I will tell you more detail about the how machine learning model will work and how machine learning will perform each and every activity in proper way. So it will be look like this one. First, we will train the data set and training the ML algorithm, that is machine learning model. And a model, we will take some input and we were providing some new input and machine learning model predict some information. We are getting the right answer, wrong answer. Maybe after predicting, we are not getting the actual information. Maybe we are not getting the actual information. So it may or may not. So depend on the our given information. We can say we are not getting the actual information like this one. Suppose we are getting the 20 degree temperature, but we are expecting that should be the 32 according to previous data. So we are getting the 32.5 temperature, then it's okay. We are getting the successfully done. But we are getting a 20 degree temperature, weather is not in our hand, weather is not the user hand. Suddenly, weather is temperatures goes down, then temperature is 20 degree now. So we can say the model is not successful. But few things are not hand. But definitely, machine learning is giving the close to the correct answer. Then we can say we have chosen the correct machine learning model or machine learning approach. So there are so many flavors. How it will work, I will tell you in deeply detailed manner from the next class, it doesn't mean. But here just I'm giving the rough idea to you, what are the various components are required to manipulate the machine learning models. So those are the data. We have some training information. Now question comes in, what do you mean by the training? What do you mean by the testing? So I will tell you in detail way when we discuss about the data set in deep manner with some example, then you will be happy to know the such answer. And we have the building the model. So why building the model? We need to build a model because according to the existing information, we are using such approach to get the to get some information in accurate way. So what we are doing, we are building some model according to our information. So this is known as the building the model. So there are the various components. Those are the algorithm, those data, machine learning algorithm, and prediction, and what we can say the outcomes. So these are the few components. So I will tell you in detail and proper with some example, then you will be happy to answer. But when talking about the example, see, I'm just right now back to my machine learning introductory part of the machine learning. So let us understand the machine learning example in proper way. Now just can anyone give me what is expecting over here? What you are thinking about it? What you are thinking about the seeing these examples, these two images? Yes, please tell me. Here we have the two images. One is the one, and now we have the second image. Now tell me what is happening over there. Can anyone tell me?
It's a basic recommendation system. The first one.
Okay. This is the recommendation system. Okay.
This is based on a user and item based recommender system.
Yes, I can agree this point. Yes. Any other student who want to speak something about having seen this in these two images, please tell me. Having seen this, these are two images. These two images are having own sense. Okay, let me give you some idea. Should I explain? Or nobody is speaking, so can I explain? Just please tell me, anyone who want to continue, or should I tell?
So what is the question? Can you repeat?
My question is simple. Having seen these images, what do you think? Which is related to the machine learning? One student is just saying this is a recommended system. Okay, I can agree this point. Another just according to you.
So second one, no, sir. It's good for machine learning.
No idea, then shall I continue? Okay. No idea, then shall I tell? I think I should tell. Should I tell?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'm just taking a simple example from a home. You and your mother are just looking for to purchase some vegetable in your market, in any market. So she is visiting. Then what is happening there? She is just trying to purchase only the potato and tomato. Okay, don't think about the carrot and banana, other thing. But suppose your mother is visiting to market to purchase only the tomato and potato, nothing else. She has only 100 rupees on the menu. But when she just see some vegetable are fresh and some vegetable are good, so she thinks, why I should come tomorrow or day after tomorrow? It is better idea to take other vegetable right now. So this is the market gambling, a market idea. Where what she thought before moving to the market, she need to purchase only the tomato and vegetable. But what he is thinking right now, after visiting my or into the during the during some time after the into the in the market, what she is thinking, I should have some more vegetable, because why I should visit tomorrow or day after tomorrow or tomorrow. This is the point. So customer who bought this item only, just like banana in the image you can see, but he or she also white what will like to purchase milk, other vegetable like carrot or fruit, other things, and cut suppose. So when you're looking for any dairy product, I'm just taking simple example, you are looking any dairy shop, then when you purchase curd and milk, then when you see the biscuit, then you have the 5 rupees more, then you will give 5 rupees more to shopkeeper to have 5 rupees biscuit. This is a fact. So this is the word. this is a market gambling or this is a machine learning approach in the mind, in the mind, in the human mind, we can say. So human learning is what? Human just learning from the past experiences. वापिस घर से जाना पड़ेगा, 10 रुपए का अच्छा बिस्किट ना मिल रहा, यहीं से 10 रुपए की ब्रेड ले लो, दूध और दही ले रहे हैं साथ में. दिस इज द अप्रोच. सो दिस इज व्हाट, दिस इज लर्निंग फ्रॉम द पास्ट एक्सपीरियंस. 10 रुपए वापिस घर जाएंगे, पेट्रोल खर्चोगे 10 रुपए की, इससे बोलते अभी ले लो. एम आई राइट? दिस इज द थिंकिंग वी हैव. सेम थिंग विल बी डन बाय द मशीन लर्निंग एज वेल. एम आई राइट? लेट मी नो दिस पॉइंट. एम आई राइट? Rather than the wasting the 20 or 25 rupees. Now petrol is very high. Petrol is 9. Now it's just too costly, more than 100 rupees liter. So it is better idea to spend 20-25 rupees, right? It is better idea to spend right now 10 rupees to have this bread and go back to the home. 10 rupees jayenge, koi baat nahi, 20 rupees to bachenge, petrol mehanga ho gaya. So this is the thing, this is the point in our mind we have the same thinking. So what the machine has? Machine has the past experience. Past experience means in the data form. So data set is known as the past experience information, which is known as the actual predefined information or existing information for machine learning. So machine will think some information from the past experience or past data set based on some algorithm. So what are the algorithm? Those algorithms are known as the machine learning technique and algorithm, and that part we will see into the coming classes. Don't worry about it. But that, what is the machine learning? So here the same thing we can go through. Now tell me, this example is clear to us. The customer is trying to purchase something, but he will purchase something more. And this is the idea. This is known as the market gambling, truly speaking. Now, is it clear to all right now? This example is clear to all. This is the first example.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, now second example I'm taking. Suppose in XYZ bank you have an account. In XYZ bank and you have an account. Suppose in your bank account you have a 10,000 rupees, 20,000 rupees, it is good. You have, then I will be happy to know that part. Then suddenly after some time or after 2 or 3 days, you will get a message or you would call from your bank side. Sir, are you interested to purchase some product? Sir, are you interested to have a personal loan and XYZ loan? Why you are not getting a call when you have a balance 500 rupees or 100,000 rupees only? Why you are getting the call when you have the big amount like 10,000, 20,000, 50,000 suppose? This is what? In bank database, virtually speaking, in a bank database, bank will filter out the information what the transaction are done by the customer. So they will keep some information, and all the transaction details are managed by the some record pattern. So the record pattern, these records are known as the data set for the bank system, and these bank will you apply some algorithm to identify the who customer will are able to get the XYZ loan, maybe the person loan or car loan, so. And this is a pie point. Okay, now is it clear to all? When you are getting the call from the bank, when you have the good amount. Now, when you're getting the call from the bank, okay, sir, you have been applied for the credit card. Now you are able to, now you can have this credit card. Now, so you have not applied, but from the bank, we are providing you credit card, so you can have the credit card. Why this lower class is who have the least amount in bank accounts, why they are not, the bank is not approaching to them. Why? Because they have a limited amount. But your father, suppose your father is rich or your father is a middle class family, they have the approximately 10,000, more than 25,000, 50,000, suppose rupees in the bank account. Definitely, your father will get a call from the bank again and again. So please have a loan, please have a loan, please have a loan. Bank will definitely disturb your father's mind. Bank always call me so many times, so please you have in our super server customer, now you please have a credit card, we have so many facility, zero credit balance, something, so many words I'm getting from bank. This is the point. So how the approach is to be done by the bank employee, this is a custom for the customer to definitely like this machine learning approach. So they have the different algorithm which is to be managed by the machine learning approach. So in the system, they have the information. So our name is there because suppose we have the 10,000 rupees, if our name is there into the credit card list. Only this is just nothing. This is all the activity features which is providing by the banks. So this is the two different example as I'm discussing over here. Okay. Yes, now tell me. After seeing these two messages, this example is clear to all? These two examples clear to all? Let me know.
Yes, it's clear.
Okay, so bank is always calling to you because why they are not approaching to the labor class? Why they are not approaching to those people who are gaining salary less than 10,000 rupees per month? No, because they know these people are not able to cope up with the credit card. These people are not able to pay the installment of the different loan. So we will not approach them. Why we are wasting money? So this is the point. Okay, so now is it clear to all right now? Tell me any doubt so far.